So, back when I recorded this song, I really did have a focus on vocal music, and I was probably 6 or 7 months into having discovered splice. So, I was using a lot of loops and samples in that way, as you can see. But I was getting to that point where I was starting to actually chop them up and trying to do some interesting stuff. I still think this is a very uncreative song. But I think I accomplished really well what I was trying to do with it. I still really love this song. I think it's a great song for the project. The main piece of the song is just this Rhodes loop, which it just plays like this. And this literally has a soundgutizer on it. So this is the basic sample. It's sped up from 70 BPM. So I time corrected it to 100, and that's all I did. And this song actually isn't even pitched up or down at all. I think this could have been a time. This was June 2022. I might have been straying away from pitching my songs up or down. I think that was around the time that I started being against that. So with the soundgutizer, it kind of gets rid of the flutter of the chords a little bit and just like compresses it a little bit type of thing. And that is literally the only chop I ever did for these was right there. At the end you can see the remnants of I was trying to do it like a won't 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 like I was gonna mute every other one on the final chord, but it sounded really bad, so I didn't do it. The next part of this is this loop, which if I were to do this song today, I would absolutely chop out. I would cut out this beginning hit right here, and I would replace it with one of the other little hats or some other noise or something, because it's actually really disruptive, and I don't even think it pitch matches with the chords. But because it's mixed very similarly, if we look, this is in channel 2 and it's pitched up from the original. It has fast distortion and chorus, so this is normally what it sounds like. With my distortion, it just gets more E, and with the chorus, it kind of flattens the sound a little bit and kind of rounds it out. This, in conjunction with the chord, sounds really nice, so I can see how it kind of just sounds like a kick drum. It's really chill. I love this song a lot. The next part of it is this. And this is a chopped one, so. I think that kick's fine, but the main star of that really is the top end, so I can see why I got my own kick for this, which is just this. Maybe, I think it's fatter, a little bit longer. And it kind of just brings in that switch. You know, there's empty space right here. It just makes it seem a little bit more robotic rather than just a drum loop. Because you can hear the loop like cut out. So then there's also this riser here, which is pretty simple. The next part is this little chop. I always snuck these in a lot of my songs around this time. I still do. The original sample is just this. It might not even play. It might be really long. There's a fly. I don't know if you just heard that, but it's like he says like pump it up, and I chopped it up just a little bit. And that's just in the intro of the song, so. And it's really quiet. It's just meant to be like a little nostalgic piece. This rain, sometimes I use rain samples that I've recorded, but I'm pretty sure this one's from Splice, just because by this point I had made a lot of songs with my main rain sample that I had recorded, and it had some like wind chimes in the background. And I think by this point I had done so many songs with that exact rain sample that I could almost like categorize, songs I used my Rain sample and songs I used other Rain samples. So I switched it up. I did this one on purpose, and this is where it loops. I don't know. You're never gonna hear that, but that wasn't good. The next part would be this. An open hat to go with the drums. Which I think fits in really well. This is really unconventional, but I think it fits in really well with the drums I already had there. It just kind of makes some more intensity. And then, of course, I also recorded myself hitting my desk and clapping to go along with the drums at multiple points in the song. And if you just hear this, this was recorded on June 4th. And so, oh, it was all one day. I thought these were on June 2nd. So I thought, well, 16, 14, 16. I can't really tell. But yeah, just me hitting my desk and clapping along. And I've done this in other songs too where I was doing vocals. Then there is the bass, which I think this is a preset I used in a lot of songs. This is pitched down just very slightly. It's the Citrus sub-bass preset, maybe with some adjusted settings, I don't remember, but it's in channel 7, so it has Wave Shaper and Sound Goodizer. So if we listen to the pattern without these, it's a pretty typical sub-bass. The Wave Shaper is almost to the max and it kind of makes it squarey, and then the Sound Goodizer just corrects it with the rest of the sound, because I use a lot of Sound Goodizer in almost every single song I make. And so yeah, that coupled with the Rain and with the drums, it's really simple, but I think I hit the sound registries correctly where it kind of just falls into place, and I really appreciate the sound even now. There's another drum loop over here, I didn't even realize. Oh, it's just like a shaker. Okay, that's also a really good addition. Wow, that fits in really well. Wait, let me hear with this. Yeah, shaker's really good. Yeah. Okay, and fine, the vocals. These actually, it's very abnormal for me to have done a song, especially during this time, with no auto-tune on it, and these vocals are not auto-tuned. And at one point on a different account, I released at least part of this song with the filter off. So this is what they sound like normally by themselves. I always wanted somebody else. And there's two channels playing because it sounds so awful. I'm not gonna play just like one of them because it sounds really bad. I'm really bad at singing. But without the filter, I think it sounds pretty good. But the drums kind of take up so much space in the mix, so it doesn't sound good with drums. But just keeping like the chords is pretty good. I always wanted somebody. So that's it with no filter and no effects at all. It sounds very similar. Like it's very raw. Really the only thing at play here is that filter, just to get that. Soft is a really generic word, but it's a soft sound. It kind of sounds, it's just like peeking through. It could be a really intense vocal while also being slow, but here it sounds like tinny on purpose. And I'm speaking kind of bigly. This is a very simple, stupid song. But I really think I hit the nail with just nailing a certain kind of sound here. Like, I remember making music for so long and wanting to make songs that had similar elements to this, like lo-fi-ish, And just with this soft vocals. And I think I hold this song so dearly because I like finally hit that sound, basically. And I didn't even know what this whole January thing would become at the time. Like, I just made this song. I kind of called it that. I was like, and I told Demon Dog, I was like, I'm gonna do 365 songs. I'm gonna do one for each one of the year. And yeah, I just had no idea where it would take me. Yeah. But I love this song. Unintentionally, the vocals are kind of muddied up right here. The lyric is, I don't want to fight myself for you. But because I hit my desk right when I said for, it kind of sounds like with. It's so weird how complicated vocals are, where if you have anything else in the mix like that, it kind of tricks your brain into thinking it sounds like something completely different. I've heard that just in other things other than music too, where it just like tricks the sound. And then finally the sample. I'll have this YouTube video linked below, but PlainRock124 is a pretty important YouTuber to me. He still inspires me literally as I speak. I watched some of his old videos today. During this time, I was really going hard in trying to get like as many things as possible to line up with 2014 and have it all like tie together. And I think it's almost insane. Some of the effort I put into some other things, but this is a video released in 2014 about Flagquake 2014, which was a earthquake in Flagstaff, Arizona, and PlainRock124 made a YouTube video about it, and
my tweet actually made it to the Google alerts for earthquakes and stuff. See right there. Wow, all this like serious people, then there's my tweet.
Earthquakes. And I don't think that really has anything to do with the song, but part of this was just super nostalgic and important to me because that end part was recorded in school and it just sounds like a really human interaction. And at this point, I was just a month out of not being in in-person school anymore. Like, I had just finished up my last year of normal high school. And, I mean, I don't know. Even now, this is, like, kind of emotional just hearing that. And I think it matches the sound very well. For how cringe and stupid it all is, I think maybe intentionally or unintentionally, I think I found the perfect little thing there. I really enjoy it.
Google alerts for earthquakes and stuff. See right there. Wow, all this like serious people. Then there's my tweet.
Yeah, very simple. I'm sure I've shared screenshots of my FLPs before, and you can see this was far before the time where I was going crazy, for lack of a better term. This literally uses, I have maxed out FLPs where I use all 125 of these before, and right here I am using 10. I mean, 11 and 12, and then 8 and 9 aren't used, and 10 was my recording, so 10. 10 FL Studio inserts. That's the song, though. That's it. And I love this song so much, despite how simple it is. And yeah, I hope this helped, or I hope this was cool to see, and thank you for watching.